Ladies and gentlemen, we are very happy to have with us four Syrian artists. Next to me is Mr. Oussama Diab, who is an artist, who is a Palestinian Syrian, who was born in Damascus and who moved to Beirut 2 years ago. Next to him is Mrs. Jumana Al-Yasiri. She is a cultural curator and a researcher. She is from Iraqi, Palestinian, and Syrian origins. She is currently living in Paris. We have with us as well Mr. Hani Sawah. He's a rapper who has moved to Beirut 2 years ago, and he is originally from Homs. Last but not least, Mrs. Afraa Batous, who is a filmmaker from Aleppo, and she's as well a singer. She has a beautiful voice. I shall start by asking some questions to our participants, and then we shall move on to the audience questions. The first question to Mr. Oussama. In your paintings, you are actually mixing between culture, as well as resistance and Nahda, the Renaissance. And in all your paintings, we can see message being conveyed in matters of politics and matters of society. Is this actually part of your work in art, or is it actually part of the conflict currently taking place in Syria, which has affected your communication and as well as the transparency that is well shown in your paintings? Good evening. No, it's not the Syrian culture that has actually aroused in me this pattern of art. I already had this pattern of art. Our region is a region of starting with the Palestinian cause, the Iraqi crisis, and the current crisis as well in Syria, as well as everywhere in the Arab world. Why I believe that this is a part of an old pattern of cultures. So the Syrian crisis is actually an opportunity for us to comment on the events, but I do not think that we can do anything more if we wanted to wait for the Syrian art to actually start producing and to actually being avant-gardist. Have, of course, to take these into account. Since you are Palestinian, you were born and you were raised in the culture of conflicts and obstacles as a refugee as well. So this Palestinian
اعترضت السؤال الاول انه هذا الشيء وجد مثل موروث معي يعني خلقت على قدر على اشكاليه بوجودي كفلسطيني انتقلت اليوم لاشكاليه وجودي كفلسطيني سوري فهي الاشكاليه موجوده اللي طرأ عليها هو ممكن انه عم تتطور ادواتك كيف بتعبر عن هذه الاشكاليه لا اكثر ولا اقل بس اشكاليه ازليه يعني عندنا
Jumama, today we are talking about the duty of artists in terms of communicating, in terms of conveying the conflict of Syria and how to express this conflict in his pieces of art. Is there any comparison between communication by Syrian artists, the Arab as well as European cultures, in terms of how to express or how to convey the conflict in Syria? Good evening. First of all, the Western artists or the European artists, as I'm living in Europe, there are many artists who have actually adopted the Syrian conflict. For example, Jonathan Dissel, who went to Syria, to Homs, who had written his diaries. Plantu as well went to draft some caricatures on Syria. Of course, the level of dealing with the cause is different. does not only translate into the pieces of art of the artists in Europe, but you can see them as well in the chases of the exhibition managers, in the policies of translation and publishing. Of course, there is a responsibility that is available among those who are more open to the world. So a question, if you see that a Syrian is expressing the conflict in his pieces of art, and when the same as well goes for Europeans, where do we see any change in terms of the expression, in terms of using the conflict? Because the has actually injured the conflict. He can live it from within, whereas the European is actually walking from a distance or observing from a distance. How does this translate into the pieces of art? To answer, it's a matter of distance. It's a matter of being capable of having not only a geographic distance, but as well to set a distance from the event and to be dealing with the topic with objectivity. For example, not only the European artist, but as well we can have an Arab artist. For example, we can have Rabi Amroui, who speaks about the revolution in Syria. Who is actually discussing the issue lightly, for example, in terms of comparing movies on YouTube with the dogma cinema. I think that this is something that's very difficult for the Syrians who are involved in the event. It's very difficult for them to actually set a distance from the conflict. I think it's too soon. Thank you, Jumana. Hani, you work in rap. You are a rapper, and rap is actually a way of expressing difficulties, conflicts, and problems that are encountered from, for example, regimes or governments. Being a Syrian, and in view of the conflict that is currently taking place in Syria, can you see yourself expressing yourself by means of singing, discussing any other matter or any other topic? Good evening. Thank you for being part of this very nice debate. It's a very difficult question to answer, because if we are talking about music, if we are talking about art as a means of expression, then it is a means of expressing anything that the artist would believe to be appropriate. If I am actually going through the conflict and I cannot express reality in my piece of art, then I may not actually stand as an artist, because it is intimately related to how you express your art, because expression and art are actually involved. And as we said, the rap expresses a state of emergency. But if we continue now, it's been 3 years. If we continue more years, will you be capable of speaking of the conflict in your pieces of work? You are asking me questions about things that I did not choose. I didn't say consciously that I want to start discussing the conflict in my songs. It has influenced me because I am living within the context of the conflict. Because I'm in Syria, it has become something normal. But if the question is whether or not people shall, for example, exit the conflict situation and speak about a completely different issue, you are telling me what you understand in terms of the revolution, in terms of the regime, in terms of the people, but I do not understand you. I do not understand the person. I do not know what you love, what you fear. Then those two matters are intrinsically related, and they actually feed into each other's. Being a rapper, do you follow on the events and of other rappers, for example, the rap in the Arab world, and how did it change compared with the beginning of the Arab Spring?
كان في ستيريوتايب معين فورا بينحط بالراس انه هذا بيغني راس معناتها هو حدا مسروق وضايج بيسمع موسيقى عاليه وبنزل بنطلون بوكسر مبين كل الوقت بس هو مو هيك. فبعد ما بلشت الثوره الناس نحن صرنا نقبل بعضنا اكثر، صرنا نقبل نسمع انه بدي اعرف بدي صرنا نقبل نتعرف مو نقبل نسمع بالاول، نقبل بس نعرف الطرف الثاني شو عنده يقول.
حتى اذا اللي بيقولوا عم نحكي بالبدايات حتى اذا اللي بيقولوا ما بيتفق مع شو انا بفكر او شو انا بحس او شو انا ونحن تغيرنا على مستوى الوعي اللي هو نحن انا شخصيا هاني ما كنت اخذ الموضوع بشكل جد كان هواي على طرف بس الشباب اللي قدروا يعملوا ثوره بسوريا بيقدروا يعملوا موسيقى ويعيشوا من وراها بس وبيقدروا يعملوا فن ويعيشوا من وراها بس
شكرا.
So now we move on to Afra. Before the revolution, you were a musician, and we can still hear your voice, which is excellent. But now you are more interested in producing movies and films that are related to the. Maybe I can have you express it better, because I know that it is not only related to the conflict that's currently taking place in Syria. Now, the situation that you have been undergoing during the past 3 years, what is it that has led you use the movie or films as means in order to express yourself? Good evening. I do not think that what happened in Syria, the conflict, was actually my choice or was not actually the trigger that had me be more interested in the cinema. I started in Aleppo, in theaters. So I had started working on theaters on a very small scale at university. Then I was a bit hesitant in terms of my choice. It was a matter of choice. So I have started with the music and the revolution started. It was only a couple of months before that I had moved to Damascus and that I had decided to work on something that's different from theater. And the revolution started. And as I had told you, this was not actually moving me to the cinema or to the filmmaking and video production. Topics that I wanted to share now can actually be shared and will not only revolve around the conflict. Because by the end of the day, art shall not only become a news broadcasting agency. Unfortunately, this is the case. This is the problem currently for Syrians. And art is becoming a news. News are actually only producing events. But artists are supposed to even act on the humanitarian side, where the revolution or the conflict later on and the war has actually put us aside. And this is why we as artists are supposed to be more attached to this humanitarian aspect that is missing in times of conflict. And people a simple matter of everyday news. It's very interesting to follow up on the humanitarian news. Yes, but when I talk about the conflict, about the impact of the conflict, I'm talking about the impact of the conflict. For example, half of the country is now made of refugees or of displaced. Their ways of living have changed. They are less educated. And when I talk about the conflict, and when I ask you, it means, does it mean that we are supposed to express the conflict from all sides and to examine how it is influencing the Syrian society? Now, if a movie is brought in Syria and that does not express the results of the conflict, will it be important? Will it be valuable for our society? The answer, the value of is not determined by the event per se, because by the end of the day, we have a humanitarian experience. We have a humanitarian, we can be influenced by the context, but there is, of course, a humanitarian experience that needs not to be neglected or marginalized because it is related to the refugees. We have a person who wishes to share a humanitarian experience that is connected to Syria. How to express it is the main question. Am I only touching upon the humanitarian level? Am I only sharing my experience? Or is it mere chaos? Or am I only in a rush? I only wish to convey a situation or to speak of an event. Sometimes, I told you, chaos would lead us apart and would have us actually examine what's actually taking place in society. Of course, there is a bond between the conflict and the art per se. However, we have to see the extent to which the artist is capable of actually bonding or coping with the conflict in order that it exceeds the fact of becoming a propaganda tool. I think that is the person who can answer us. I will actually rephrase the question. What is the role of art for society? That's a huge question. That's a question that is raised by humanity for the past 3,000 years. Of course, what I think about in terms of the Syrian situation, Afraa said something that is very true. At one point, at one moment, especially at the beginning, the Syrian artist was in a state of emergency, which means that there are news that he needed to broadcast. There is a truth that he has to highlight. There are news that were broadcasted, however, not properly. So at one point, the Syrian artist has become half a reporter. And with time, there are many artistic figures that have shown during the first couple of years and that we couldn't see in terms of Facebook pages, in terms of creatives who are producing movies. Because with time, when we talk about art, we have something called art. And we need, of course, to have art that is up to the level of the historic event. It's not a matter of commenting the historic event, because now we are in a state of war, in a state of revolution. There is something that could take longer in time. However, I think that it is the duty of the Syrian artist first to maintain a memory. And the artistic pieces of art were not born from void. There is, of course, cultural patrimony and heritage that is related to new ethics, to new beauties, and to new revolutions. There is something that occurred that has led to a revolution. And now we are developing new elements, new aesthetics. I expect that some people have actually used art. Those persons are not artists or shall not continue as artists. Is that true? Maybe in terms of music, there are people who have used rap and music to express themselves. Does that mean that they were artists or that they will continue down the art journey? When we talk about art, we have to know how to define artists. Who do I include by the definition of artists, or when I that those are artists? If they all, for example, produce pieces of art, if this is the definition, then any person who has produced even one piece of art in his life is an artist. Whereas when we say that artists are the persons who work in art, which means those persons who are actually living from the revenues of their paintings, for example, it's similar to a carpenter, it's similar to a handcraft person. So here, of course, it does not fall within the category, because and no one can it, and no one can actually live from the revenues of this art, because otherwise he's not living from the products of his art. Oussama, to comment on what was mentioned by Hani, you said that the revolution did not actually affect largely your products. Is it maybe because you were an artist a long time ago, and because you had already understood the means that you expressing yourself, and because you already had your interests in that you tried to convey? It's not that it did not affect me. So actually what I mean is that the message that you convey in your pieces of art did not change. It's maybe because I already had a cause. So it was not something new to me to actually go into this ambiance situation. It could develop with time, and this doesn't have to do with the event per se. There is, of course, a development in terms of the artistic production. example, the conflict has triggered more this message, but that's it. I would like to say something that's very specific in terms of this discussion pertaining to art in our Arab region. We must not link one to another. We were discussing the documentation of an event. It's not about actually building a new space for art. And I think that building this new space requires stability, and this is a must. The World War II did not produce anything until it settled down. Thank you. Any question from the audience? Questions? Sana? Yes? Good evening. I have a series of questions addressed to almost everyone. So the question was, and the dialogue was very brief, and we have a lot to say because, of course, we would like to open the floor for debate. A first question addressed to Oussama. Maybe you could better explain to us, since we still do not have this distance required, which is only known by the so-called artist, the one who is actually experiencing of the distance and the results of the events. So today we have two types. We have the human being, any Syrian human being who has produced and who has large products. This is, of course, a phenomenon. What is art? What is not art? This as well is a matter of research. But there is actually a production. It's a creative production. We have to see to what extent it abides by the artistic characteristics. If it's actually a matter of creation, it means that the person is an artist. This, of course, deserves discussion. This discussion is very important so that we can understand the extent to which this conflict has opened new perspectives for us as Syrians. We need, of course, to dig into the process deeper and deeper. Now, the question is about the content of the piece of art, of the painting. The technique could be the same. Maybe, for example, the artist will maintain his own style, his own pattern. However, the content, didn't the content of the painting change? Don't you think that it should change in order to reflect the reality? Maybe you can bear testimony to this. The answer. We have a topic. So it's not actually the topic that specifies the type of art. In the past, for example, you used a simple pattern. For example, you could use, for example, the painting of a woman, and now it's actually the painting on a martyr. But when we talk about the second level of art, when we talk about surrealistic paintings, it means that you are producing a new theory in art. I believe that this is a huge burden to carry. Let's not go into this. Don't you think that this is actually a major change? Won't the Syrian artist be capable of reflecting this reality? Of course, paintings did not have their audience. Now, what you are saying is that we have a larger space of freedom and of liberty. But here, we're talking about how to develop art. The space of freedom is not the one that adds up or that affects the production of the painting. And I do hope this is well, the technique is the same. What you're saying is something very enormous, and it needs a lot of time to change patterns. So far in our pieces of art, we are still very fresh, and it only dates back to 50 or 60 years ago, and everything that we are building is related to Western productions. So today, for example, when we say that this art is Palestinian or Syrian, I have a problem in this very specific categorization. Maybe in our topics, maybe in our, for example, characteristics, but did we produce a new theory for art? Then I believe that this is actually, this would be messy. Maybe I can address the question to Hani in terms of music and rap, the space of freedom, the new space of freedom that has opened up during the past couple of years? How did it affect the situation? Allow me simply to comment on the discussions that have taken place. First of all, I think that it's obvious. It's perfectly sense that the content of pieces of art produced by any artist will change before and after the conflict. But of course, we have more freedom, not only in terms of expression. Even today, when I have an approach of music, I do not approach music from an academic perspective, because the academic perspective is all dated. I do not want to be an ISIS in terms of culture. I do not want to go to the basis, to the grounds. There are, for example, some rules that are decreed. And I think that rap is actually taking this margin of freedom even before the conflict had started in Syria and elsewhere as a piece of art. But today, concepts have changed and the frameworks have changed. Who says that if I have, for example, this line, then I needed to draw a different line? Or who says that if I use the word here, it means that the word that comes after is supposed to be within the same rhythm? I think that those who work as artists, be it of writing or in terms of painting, now I can see that a question is imposed. Not only shall we talk or not about the conflict, there is as well a question about how to discuss the conflict. Some are saying that after this euphoria of accompanying the event, and every day, for example, we have explosions, and tomorrow we can have a million paintings and graffitis. Today we are discussing matters from different of the representation. How are we to represent those elements, and how can we look for tools in terms of music? When we start talking about those matters, we can start being involved in the creation process. It's not only a matter of documentation. Is this part of the change in terms of the audience, because the Syrians in Syria were a specific audience? It is, it has expanded. However, it was smaller. And since we are now more focusing more on Syria and the Syrians, I think that we have opportunities and we have a larger scope for artists. Maybe this is what has triggered the situation. When we have a defense, when we have an audience, this has led to a better responsibility in order to use the opportunity and to express our country, be it our conflict or our heritage. A matter of major concerns, because I think that it is on two levels. We have artists who are within Syria or elsewhere. However, gradually they are going to Europe, they are going to other countries. You have of course, the discussion that is taking place with the audience in the country where we are living, and there is a question that is asked by the Syrian artist who says that we needed to maintain this contact with the inside, because of course curators, translators, exhibition directors are interested in the Syrian production. But how can we speak with what's inside? Afra, ever since you had left Syria, you went on visiting as much as possible and engaging in dialogues inside and outside. How did this affect your work? I do not actually stand in favor of this idea of the inside, because it has caused the problems. And raising this issue has actually established some kind of a wall between the inside. What was supposed to happen is that we can maybe have a beehive and to have people working. We're talking geographically. Even on the level of the expression, we are faced with this problem. As a person who is working from outside is lesser than your credibility as a person working from within, and the sacrifices for you as a person from outside are lesser than the sacrifices of a person who is living inside, which means that you who are living is less capable of expressing yourself, which means that a person, for example, who is within Aleppo has more credibility from someone who has spoken of Aleppo while being abroad. This is a problem. This is a problem because opportunities are given to those who are outside, which means that communication between the two could lead to a larger expression. I simply wanted to say that I was not only talking about legality, I was talking about the geographic communication, about the language, all those matters that are actually a matter of truth in our life, how to discuss with people, how to engage in conversations, especially for the people who believe that their language is their tool. When they go to Denmark, when they go to Sweden, they have to know who is it that they are addressing. Those are the questions that are raised. It's not a matter of legitimacy. So fast, I think, internet, there is no problem. I think that geographic distance has become a virtual distance. No one can say that I cannot access those who are living inside Syria because I'm not in Syria, because I can access them. Now, what's weird is that I have a better communication with the people from within Syria. I settled here instead, compared with the communication I had with the people in Syria when I was inside, in Idlib, in Damascus, in Deir ez-Zor, and we have people who listen to Arabic rap. And they listen to Arabic rap, not only my rap, but many people, they are more exposed to the art that is actually made available in terms of painting, in terms of, and in the event of documentaries, I think that the situation is more specific because we did not have journalists in Syria. This is why the people in Syria or the locals became journalists, and this is why documentaries have become information films in order to register a specific event and not only to convey a message, and we do not have the characteristic of a film producer. If you are talking or if you are thinking something different than the conflict, would you have such a large audience in Syria? To start the discussion from the perspective that no one can actually be working in art or elsewhere without affected by the conflict. If I, as a human being, cannot say actually, obviously, that I am affected, I am, apologies for interrupting you, says Reem, but you're saying that we have a larger audience that is interested. Is it because the rap message is actually around the obstacles and the problems? You are a human being. It's true that you are an artist and you are Syrian and that you had to leave. But maybe, for example, wish to talk about a relationship and you want to talk about the obstacles in love. Would you believe that there is an for this kind of songs? The answer, if I am actually turning the page of a conflict in Syria and if I am to talk about a love relationship, what kind will I be talking about? Will it not be a love relationship within the conflict? Which means that the person who is actually living in the conflict would be influenced. Maybe you want to talk about a love experience before the conflict. So this is my question, and this is what you and which actually determines the value of art. We are all involved. Yes, that's true. We are not negatively involved. We are part of it, but. Let's suppose that I would like to produce a movie on my personal experience as a woman in the Arab society, in the Arab nation, in Aleppo, before the revolution, as a girl who is living in a conservative society. I was having trouble in terms of going outside the society. So the question is, doesn't this value, doesn't this act, for example, or doesn't this production carry a value? If you are doing something that has happened 10 years ago, you cannot do it as someone who is actually living outside the conflict. You are someone who lived the conflict. So whether you like it or not, you are bound to speak about the experiences that you have lived, about the problems that you had to endure. Maybe it wouldn't have occurred to you to have a movie on your situation as a woman in Syria if the revolution did not take place. So I think that this relation is a matter of common sense. It happens even without we saying out and loud that we want to be influenced, even those who stayed at home and did not. Of course, it's a period of time. During this period of time, we have a war, and it's a matter of the different components of society. Allow me simply to answer questions that were raised. I do not think that the number of the audience has increased. Now, the problem of the conflict in Syria has actually led the audience to be better curious, to be better information. Because everywhere in Syria, or the whole Syria, is now involved in this conflict. And this is why they would like to look at the painting, watch the documentary, listen to the rap. And this curiosity is the one that has led to a better communication between the artist and the people. It's a matter of knowledge. There are organizations and bodies who are giving us an opportunity as a Syrian artists. They are giving us the opportunity by means of grants or by means of training. Now, you are giving me this opportunity because you have been introduced to my country as a result of the conflict. Do I have, therefore, a duty to only talk about the conflict or not? Or are you giving me an opportunity because I have more freedom? Now, to go back to the question, is there any responsibility, is there any obligation for me during this period of time to only talk about the conflict and the crisis and the problems arising from the crisis, or can I simply talk about love? Can I talk about my situation as a woman, the problems I encounter as a mother? I personally believe actions are a self-flagellation. As mentioned by Hani, any person, an artist or a non-artist, could be interested in what's going on in Syria, whether he is Lebanese or Egyptian. So I do not think that you can actually separate someone from what's going on, especially if it's related to the conflict, and he could actually produce something that is related to law, for example. And since now he is involved, he could actually produce it from a different perspective, not even while mentioning the conflict. So it's not a matter about talking about how separated or not separated you are from the conflict. How can you be separated? I think that the idea is inhuman. No one can be separated. A 5 years old a child is not today separated from what's taking place. Then the same, of course, goes for people who have experiences and who have memory. But of course, today many people who are working in Syria are now dealing with what happened, such as, for example, Firas Hamzawi. And this is someone who is completely distant from the situation. This person believes that he is living within an international conspiracy who are coming to kill the person that we are all fond of. Now, what's very important and what we had lived through, or the two positive elements that are very important to the revolution, are that first, now we can express ourselves, and second, that the revolution has redefined the small cycles that created. And today they see who have started working in art after the conflict, they look at them as being outsiders. But on the contrary, today we are witnessing a very long process to have a Syrian actor come and attend a rap show. That was impossible, because in the past we had the small circles. Now the conflict had redefined the pyramid, has reshaped the cultural situation or the artist spectrum. It's not as if they were closed to their old ones, to Mahmoud Darwish, to Ghassan, and those are actually confined within very limited circles. And of course, we cannot only be limited to those four poets that come from our land. So the issue is that we were capable of filling the gap between art and society. It's good that we can have, for example, having a short movie. It's very good to have the idea of short movies in Syria, which was not known to many people who were never in Al-Khaldi. Yes, a question. قد لفتني إذا طرح هذا السؤال لأنني أعتقد إنه أعتقد بأنه كناية عن الحديث عن العواقب المفروضة على الفنيين في ظل النظام الفائت. لكل منا إذن واجبه السياسي، وبالتالي لا يمكننا أن نكون فنانين وأن ننتج إذن هذا النتاج الفني، وهذا ليس هو الواجب، هذا هو الواجب الأساسي للفنان أن ينتج إذن تحفة فنية. السؤال الذي أطرحه هو على الشكل التالي: يبدو إنه سؤال فظيع لأنه يندرج ضمن إطار الخلفية السياسية القديمة، وكأننا نسألهم مثلا ما الذي تفعلونه لصالح الأمة. السؤال الذي أود أن أطرحه هو أن بعض المعطيات قد اختلفت منذ هذه الثورة، ولكن كيف غيرت نظرة المجتمع حيال عملكم، وكيف مراقبة هذه المعطيات سيما في ظل شعوري بالمسؤوليات، وهي يعني كيف تجاوب الجمهور ومع وجود إذا جمهور جديد؟ وأود أيضا أن أسمع رأيك بشأن هذا الموضوع. هناك إذا أشخاص يلقون نفسهم في عالم الإنتاج الجديد، يتم هذا الأمر وكيف يتجلى في هذه المرحلة؟ And to rephrase the question, so the question that we are asking today is similar to the questions that were actually asked by the governments in the past. You artists, what are you doing? What is your responsibility? So this is the major question. And how is the audience actually coping? How are they reacting to your pieces of art today compared with the past? Allow me to answer the question and to follow up on what was said by our colleague here. We cannot, of course, point accusing fingers at each other, so whether or not you are producing. Now, our presence today here in the conflict is a responsibility that we are all shouldering. So how you would like to produce art, then I do not think that anyone can place anyone within the circle of accusations. As an artist, when you have chosen to be in this place, you have chosen this out of your own will, and this is why your expression is a matter of free will. And even how the other is accusing you is his own problem. How much have you produced? And you were abroad and the other one was inside. Now, I think that if you are to produce anything that's beautiful, then let's do it all together without pointing fingers of accusation at each other's. First of all, when the dictator, when the government, or when the the artist, what you have produced needs to be differentiated from my perspective in terms of how to approach those artists that have dealt with the revolution. Now, I can ask them, are you selling us or are you not selling us? We are actually purchasing your pieces of art. We are actually going to buy your pieces of art. But at one point, the Syrian artist, the Syrian cultureman, and one of them, of course, was a relative of mine who was a role model to me. Me, as a person who is a son of the people, I have the right to ask you, as an artist, what is the value added that you are bringing to me? This is, of course, at one point where I need you. Sometimes, during a demonstration, a person at Bab al-Sbab, and who is actually a butcher, he came to me and he asked me, "You look like a university student." A university student. Apparently, you know how to speak. Then why don't you get your folks here so that you can talk to us, because we cannot talk? Because at one point, people in the street knew that they are unable to maintain the full mobilization that we wanted to reach in order to, of course, those elements reflected. Now, I think that as a person, I have the right to ask artists about what they have achieved. To answer your question, today, we were capable of actually changing the concept of art in the minds of people. So who is the artist? How does an artist differentiate himself from me? Is he better? Is he worse? So here we have broken the ice. It's not a matter of distinction. No one is distinguished anymore. It's the result, it's the end product that can determine whether or not you can actually produce. I'm not sure that I answered your question. Afra, as a filmmaker, working with people who as well produce movies, I know that you work on documentaries and on cultural movies. The reaction of the audience to both types of the movies, can you maybe share it with us? Is there any difference? So we have the satire movies, the sarcastic movies. We have the cultural matters that are based and founded on cultural grounds. And you have worked with both, with people who work on two different types of movies. How do you see the reaction of people? I'm trying to understand whether the people are interested in what Jumana showed. She said that now we are in an autistic domain where we are talking about the events that are taking place. Or on the contrary, are we actually expressing a cultural event? I'll try to answer your question. I work in an institution that produces films, and that is called Bidayat. People interaction is well determined. We have an institution that is established and that has started with the beginning. It speaks of the revolution in the and in the what is called the clips or the sarcastic clips. Now, the interaction was more or was better with the sarcastic movies and with the music, because it's easier to have a music accessible to people than a movie. A movie is not that accessible to the people compared to it is always accompanying us. Now, I think that this is the reason why people were have interacted better with us than with the movie. Now, I will talk about my fears at this point. Regarding the documentary, I totally agree with you that we are all influenced and affected. But when you have the same picture, the same scene, it's as if you were producing the same news. It becomes boring. I'm talking about the image most particularly. Unfortunately, boring because I think that the Syrian cause has been exploited, has been drained. It has become current news, usual news, routine. I feel incapable, and this, but I can do nothing. It is the duty of the person who is involved in the event. It is his duty as someone who is involved in the picture this consumption approach, to go even deeper, to go to the elements that actually touch upon you. Because we need, of course, to go deep in ourselves in order to speak of something. This is, of course, what I fear about the documentary or the movie, and to have it become something similar to news, to be actually exploited, to be drained. It's about changing. The picture can change a lot, because the fact that we learn in life is the image and the sound. We see things. We learn. So to what extent are we capable of using the tool that we have available? Digging deep into ourselves and by speaking out and loud. We have to be outspoken with ourselves in order to convey the message. When I feel pressured that now I need to broadcast or to publish a specific image, this will produce no change. Maybe another question from the audience? Go ahead. I'll say one thing about the artists before and after the revolution. It's as if we have a conflict and as if we were actually accusing each other. And we have to know, what are you supposed to produce now? I believe that the piece of art or that art is more complex. And you are totally right. Most of the artists are not academicians. Those are not people who can produce art for a very simple reason. The artists during the revolution have tried, in as far as possible, to express their feelings. The artists who have a long or a small experience said that well, can have a specific capacity, because I can, of course, work on breaching censorship under the regime. But doesn't it mean that I have actually been affected now that censorship is lifted and that the started? I was all the time thinking, how can such a revolution as a change my language? And now that I am capable of producing things that I couldn't produce in the past. So this is actually this long reflection. And of course, this applies to other Syrian artists in Syria. This has taken me 4 years. And for some other peoples, it could take even shorter. And they are related to the suffering. And it has enriched the past piece of art. Now you can see that it's not about abolishing old artists. For example, Oussama Muhammad, who is a part of the traditional movie, the conflict has affected it. His pieces of art are now available, which means that art is actually affecting him. So what I mean, bottom line, is that the cinema that we had under the conflict has actually changed the old cinema, producing hence a new type of production. Thank you much for your contribution. So now we will have to close for today, but of course it is an opportunity for everyone, of course, to share with us their last ideas. Hani, maybe last thoughts. So, of course, I had this idea at the beginning, but now in your intervention, it has crystallized. As an artist, I'm not the only one who is speaking of art. No one can actually approach art as a thesis. I cannot say that in the past, for example, inspiration was produced by 1, 2, 3, and 4, which means that I have to do 1, 2, 3, and 4 in order to have inspiration. Now, I am writing and producing again, but I had stopped for a year and a half, and I didn't know why I had stopped, because I did not approach matter from a specific perspective. It means that I have to stop writing on the artistic idea. It becomes, of course, systematic. Thank you. Today, within this title, which is Art and Conflict in Syria, I think that the question per se is a very difficult matter. It's important to start asking this question. Of course, you have to understand how the product is made. We have, of course, to produce a piece of art calmly, with stability. That we are living is supposed, of course, to affect the identity of our culture, because we are all going through experiences and we are having chances, opportunities, old, and of course the generation that is now growing, of course, will encounter new situations. I wanted to comment on many things of opportunities and the donors, but here, of course, it's the issue. Those donors, in their guidelines, often are imposing indirectly on Syrian and Arab artists one narration, one perspective. What Afraa was saying in terms of having different perspectives that are influencing us, that we can have different approaches. Now, at Syrian, the Syrian artist, if he's not actually distributing Pampers with the painting, then it's a problem. And this is something that is putting our aesthetics, our pieces of art at risk. And this is, of course, putting at risk our creativity. Sometimes, of course, the silence of an artist is as well the position. What Sodo is saying is very true. Sometimes, of course, an artist could express himself and express the conflict by remaining, especially that we are talking about the elderly, about people who had suffered from wars, from feelings of despair. Those are people who need time, and the events are running so fast. And this silence is actually something. Afraa, do you share Jumana, or do I remain silent? The Syrian society is changing, and hopefully it's going towards the best. This is the product of the revolution. Last long, it will take longer. Someone can, for example, produce something, and some others could produce pieces of art in the future. For example, now I cannot be in Syria. I cannot change inside Syria. Maybe in 2 or 5 years, I will be back in Syria. So if I cannot be up to the expectations of the new Syria, it's a problem. I am supposed, of course, to strengthen my tools. Otherwise, it will be a loss in terms of time. I would like to thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank the audience, Mrs. Alexandra Sandals, Patrick, and Galois, the translator. We would like to thank Patrick for the Hypernation live stream as well. I would like to thank those who are following us live stream. Unfortunately, at Zico House, I would like to thank Zico. It was a pleasure to follow our discussion and debate. We can, of course, continue by means of Facebook. We can continue our discussion. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.